I always tell people that I breed molecules like you can breed dogs and cats. I can make a lot of very funny looking molecules. I can make some very beautiful molecules. I can make some molecules that solve real problems and are extremely useful. My lab at the California Institute of Technology studies the biological world and how it's designed, and we try to build new biological things in the laboratory by evolution. All of the molecules that biology makes are beautiful in the sense that they're finely tuned and extremely well adapted for their functions in the natural world. I can make molecules that are just as finely tuned and well adapted to do the things that I want them to do. We're working on a whole array of problems. Things like, how do you cure a disease? Or what are the solutions to the energy crisis? One of the problems that we're working on now is how do you use the ability of plants to suck CO2 out of the atmosphere and to use sunlight to create new chemicals and materials. We would like to be able to convert this renewable biomass into fuels and chemicals so that we don't have to pump it out of the ground anymore. This is the foundation of a whole new technology that can replace fossil fuels, that can replace a lot of toxic processes in the chemical industry, that can provide new therapeutic proteins to cure cancer, that basically can do a lot of the things that we need to have done. I don't think we should be afraid of modifying the biological world. Humans have been doing that for 50,000 years or more. Here's an opportunity to solve real problems using that technology. There's no way that we're going to feed and clothe and house 9 billion people on the planet unless we learn how to do what biology already knows how to do.